We are currently sitting off Tathra Head, heading for Kainini Bay. A lovely little bolt hole to put in and take out these sea stumps here. Are formed of igneous rhyolite, as indeed is the shoreline. What was that, Jez? Give us
the...
She saved us off with the high breeze. I know. Give us the American lady. Yeah.
Oh, God.
This coastline can be nondescript to the newcomer. In front of us there, I don't know if this camera will pick it up. There's a navigational white triangle painted on the cliff up there as a guide into the Kainini bolt hole. And we are just coming up on it now. This is the rubble side of it. We'll have a little sticky bit. Look at that, turn everywhere. Beautiful. We'll now go over to the navigation marker and look back into the bay. There's the navigation marker. We turn and we look into this wonderful bolt hole. Obviously, South Coast fishers in this area launch their boats, etc., and absolutely love it. And there goes one ducking in now. Okay, not a good idea for canoes to sit over. Not a good idea for paddlers to sit over a bait ball. As you can see there. And the turn had just gone crazy. They're coming in under my kayak for cover. And of course, we'll have a look. We've decided to move away from this bait ball. Because this rock feature here is what creates the shelter that is Kainini Bay from the open sea in this area of coastline. That is one lovely little arch. And then, of course, there's the kelp with a bit of strapweed. Back to the bay, guys! Coming back into Kainini proper. And there's the fluorescent channel markers with light. Looking into the site by itself. Well protected from nearly all conditions. But never count on it. Beautiful purple colour at the moment. Inside the rubble area. Remnant rails from the old slipways.